Hello everybody, and welcome back to Destiny 2. I am incredibly tired, and there's going to be a Nintendo Direct happening as we're recording this in 20 minutes. I'm not going to say I'm going to drop the entire video to watch Nintendo Direct, but I would like to be able to watch it before I get spoiled on things, so. Hi, Saint!
I see you. You see me too? Ha, good, good. Then it is all working. You, me, this projector. Even if sometimes falter. There is a war building in Sloane's eyes. One that Zivu Arath will exploit as she did with Osiris. Savathun wore his face, but it was Zivu Arath who took his light. Her whips drove him into a frenzy, lured him into danger, forced Sagira's sacrifice, and left him. Die. Now she twists my thoughts into thorns, draws out the faces of the suffering Elixni into my dreams. She whispers that I took pleasure in their pain. I see their eyes as they died by my hands, and they see me. She does not lie. She challenges what you hold as a strength. Osiris's ambition, my protection, Sloane's duty. I have felt how the right word, the right face, can incite one to violence. But I have changed. What she has taken, it will not break me. Sloane is no warrior of glass. But the war within her. Even stone crumbles under enough strife. Stay with her, Guardian, as I should have with Osiris. We must offer her what support we are able, even if she does not want it.
Okay. Check in with Drifter via the helm. Okay. Go with... I've already gotten that done. I'm gonna go with the... hand cannon just because I have no progress on it. Get rid of this. So we're gonna grab our bounties like normal. Then defeat Hathric the Glassweird in the Extraction Lost Sector in Savathun's Throne World. Okay. Should be pretty easy to do that. I have seen that there's a cutscene today. That is why the model is on. Oh, it's in this one. Easy. Anyway, we're gonna hop on over here. Ow. that one. I'm not gonna do the public event. I don't need to do the public event. Off we go into the depths. Yeah, there's an entire ass Lost Sector too. It's not one of the short ones either, it's actually like one of the more decently long ones. Head on through here. To the next area, I believe it is the wizard in this one. Clear all these enemies out, capture the plates. And kill the enemies. Get over here. Come on. There we go. Finish your chair! Anyway. Off we go. Oh, I'm out of special. Oof. Alright, whereabouts is this sucker? There's Hathrick. Let's focus on them. Crunch, hive ghost fragments. Look at that, just so we can get the XP for it. We're going to the helm now. Bit too odd. Ow. I'm being shot at. There we go. We're fine. Okie dokie. I haven't done any much fishing since last time, but been working on it. I got my season found, so that's all that matters to me. I'm just going straight into the cutscene. Deposit arrow or coral. Cutscene.
Before you can confront the witness, you must understand it. The witness's first victims were once like you, struggling for survival, bolstered by hope, until their hopes became reality. They called it the Gardener, their deity of life. It ushered them into a golden age. For eons, they prospered. But their newfound god never spoke to them. It lavished them with gifts, but not with guidance. And though they lived in paradise, they came to crave a greater purpose. They desired meaning, structure, a winnower. To shape the garden. Their scholars discovered that the gardener shared a connection with another entity among the stars. They called it the Veil. And when they found it, they arrived to claim it. They already knew much about the light, how it could bend the laws of the universe and create life. But they came to realize that it could bring ruin just as easily. The cosmic events it set in motion could wipe out entire civilizations in a heartbeat, without reason. And so they saw the light, not as a source of prosperity, but of unfettered chaos. By studying the Veil, they came to know the darkness, a power that was shaped by thought and consciousness. And in the darkness, they found the means to carve away the chaos of existence, to calcify it into a final shape, eternal and perfected. They brought the Veil back to the Gardener in an attempt to strengthen their connection. There, they could reshape reality itself. The Gardener would not allow it. And so it fled their world. But they would not be deterred. Having witnessed the truth in the darkness, they used its binding power to merge themselves into the salvation they craved. Thus began the witness's pursuit, its campaign to impose meaning on a meaningless universe. One that is nearly at its end.
Yeah.
Alright then. Okay. So the veil is just the equivalent of... It is just the Darkness Traveler then. That's why it's linked to it. Oh god, it's so confusing.
Well, now we've heard what Asa had to tell us. We know our enemy better than ever. To think that it all started with the need for purpose. How that need became an obsession. What bothers me most is how much I understand it. This mission. It's my purpose, my reason for being. My guiding light. Without it, I'm lost. I don't know who I am or what I'm supposed to do. And that lack of direction, it's harder to face than 1,000 battles. I felt the same about my previous mission when I held the line on Titan. And if I'm being honest, it feels like I failed. I survived, but for what reason? What was it all meant to achieve? The only answer I've found is to learn what Asa knows. If I can do that, it will all have been worth it. Our link ended before Asa could explain how to get through the portal. The bond took its toll. But we'll both be ready again soon. When that time has come and gone, then I can feel like I accomplished the mission.
Okay. Obviously. Well, let me claim the triumphs first, that way. Stop yelling at me. One more week. Looks like. Oh yeah, this is from... Golf ball. All right, last thing.
You never did tell me why you trust the Nine so much.
Oh, I don't. Not even a little. I trust Orin.
Orin?
Long story. The short of it is, I may have had a feeling or two for somebody a long time ago. Somebody that lost themselves along the way. But there's a little piece of her still out there, a sliver, who still has a feeling or two for the somebody I could be. So I trust her, because she ain't never steered me wrong, no matter how rotten I was. Because at the end of the day, maybe we gotta put our faith in something other than ourselves, even if we're too stubborn to admit it.
I didn't expect you to put a lot of stock in faith.
I didn't expect you to lose yours and keep moving. Guess we're all full of surprises, ain't we?
I'm giving you the benefit of the doubt that you're being genuine.
Oh, I'm always genuine. People just ain't always paying attention. For real, though, Moondust might have given me a push. Thought it'd help.
Sounds like familiar advice. Is it, though? Helping?
No joke?
Interesting. And then lastly, I'm going to go do the veil thing, so I'll be back momentarily, because I actually forgot to record that, but I'll be back momentarily.
Chioma Essie, research log. SIVA. SIVA is a nanotech fabrication system. intended to be used by Exodus ships to rapidly build necessary resources from base matter. Maya calls it Willa Bray's obsession, without a hint of self-awareness. But we both see the potential it poses for the future. Each nanomachine in Siva's design is an independent, thinking machine, utilizing a distributed quantum network to coordinate movement. Like a mechanical version of Radiolaria. Probably where the design was inspired from, if I'm being honest. But the design can be pushed. We're looking at ways of incorporating components from disabled Vex and erased Exomines. If we can insulate the nanomachines from the radiation that killed the Exos, maybe... maybe their deaths won't be for nothing.
Wait. Does this really mean I'm part Vex?
Well, it's too early to jump to these conclusions, Nimbus. But there does seem to be some connection between the Vex and the Cloudstriders. It may explain why you and the others are able to enter the Vex network without the aid of splicers.
Can I time travel?
No, let's hope not.
Well, that's basically what I was figuring. That, Cloudstriders are imbued by Vex tech. And darkness. So, hey, there's that. But, I'll see you guys in 3 hours for to make. Have a good day, everybody. Stay safe, all that fun stuff. And, yeah, I'm gonna go continue watching the direct now. And I'll see you guys tomorrow for stuff.